I present The Last Baby Boomer.
An xtranormal play. In one act.
Good morning, Mr. Fogg. Are you feeling all right?
I feel okay, although sometimes I forget things. Tell me, what year is this?
For the purposes of this tale, we will say it is a not too distant future.
Gotcha. Disbelief suspended.
Good. Mr. Fogg, I am afraid I have some very bad news for you. You know your old friend and business associate, Pete the Foolishite? Well, he died last night.
Do you know what that means? I win me. I win.
You are getting too excited, you need to calm down.
I am the sole survivor. The last Mohican. The Omega Man. Wow. Old Foolishite finally bit it. Now I am the last living baby boomer.
Oh, no, don't start, please now.
Did I ever tell you about the summer of 68?
Help me, Lord.
Yes, we were changing the world back then. We took it to the streets and kept it real. Yes, we learned that truth is just a matter of which doors of perception we opened.
Oh, bullcrap.
No, really, I was in Chicago in Grant Park during the 68 Democratic Convention. For 5 days we protested.
How did you protest?
We stayed in the park after curfew.
Wow. That is really sticking it to the man.
We tore down society's conventions. People of my generation refused to compromise their beliefs. Why, in my day and age?
Shut up. There is nothing left of your day and age. Nothing but scar tissue and untold trillions of dollars in debt. Maybe in the summer of 68 you stood for something, but in the end, all you did, you bloated bastards, is to turn the country into a coast-to-coast strip mall.
Never.
The only useful thing to come out of the baby boom was a personal computer. And even then, aren't you blindly placing all your eggs in one digital basket? Aren't you worried about maintaining the complexity of the current mode of communication? I mean, when one super solar storm could potentially wreak havoc on business and governments around the world?
Nope. It will all work out.
Unbelievable.
But what about civil rights? My generation made that happen.
You taking credit for any improvements in civil rights is like a rooster taking credit for the sunrise. Besides, why are the prisons filled with minorities?
Maybe because of all the crimes they commit?
No, white-collar crime outstrips all other forms of crime combined. So why aren't white-collar criminals filling the prisons?
Well, white-collar crimes are not violent crimes.
How violent do you have to be when you have access to that kind of crime?
Okay, what about space travel?
What about disco?
That wasn't my fault.
But you didn't do anything to stop it, did you? What you did manage to accomplish was this. You gave the expectation to every American that they will have 15 minutes of fame. You so believed in celebrity that you were at your happiest when Reagan was in office. But then you didn't pass the torch to the next generation. You leased it with a variable interest rate. When they couldn't pay up, you took back all the wealth, then floated safely away on a golden parachute.
We fought for equal rights for women.
Well, all you did was bring the divorce rate up to 50%. You didn't need children working in your coal mine, so you turned them into commodities for divorce lawyers to divvy up funds at the end of a marriage. You promoted greed and selfishness. You bankrupt every government program designed to help those in need, because you are like locusts devouring everything in your path. I hate you.
Well, that is just your truth. My truth is very different.
Right. Because to a baby boomer, truth is just a matter of perception. And isn't that convenient? Because if there is no such thing as truth, then there is no such thing as a lie. Isn't that correct?
Correct.
Oh, you gotta love that. That is your legacy. You honestly think you can do or say whatever you want, because everything will work out fine after the last commercial break? With that kind of thinking, you hijacked the American dream, then crashed it into the fruited plain. You self-centered bastards. All you did was extinguish the flame of liberty with your bung water. How can it be that you don't see this, you two-faced assholes? You protested Vietnam, then engineered wars in Iraq and Afghanistan. You did it for money. Oil and money. Everything you did, everything revolved around making a profit.
Just promoting freedom. I seem to remember something about weapons of mass. Oh, never mind.
I understand. You grew up believing that the world was going to end in a nuclear war. What surprises me is that you haven't brought that to pass. I mean, all of your movies and TV shows say it will happen, therefore it must.
You have a point there. I have to admit, I am a little disappointed in that. I was going to go all Mad Max on them. But now that I am the last man alive,
Boomer.
The last boomer alive, I don't see much point.
Well, are there any of society's conventions left for you to destroy?
Oh, let's see. Is it okay to use torture to get what you want?
Yep.
No, then I think we are done.
Very well then, Mr. Fogg.
Yes?
My eyes are up here.
Sorry.